Pennsylvania is now the sixth state in the country to ban what redistricting reformers are calling prison gerrymandering. It's when state prisoners are counted as residents of their district that the prison's located in and not necessarily where they're from. Matt Maisel explains why we'll have major impact on how future maps are drawn in tonight's Fox 43 Capitol Beat report.
Pennsylvania is about to see a population shift of about 37,000 people. State prisoners will soon be counted in the House and Senate districts where they last lived.
The majority of the folks that are in those prisons in the rural areas come from urban areas. So you're not redistributing them evenly across the state.
Dickinson political scientist Sarah Niebler says the decision is expected to shift population from the state's 24 prisons to urban centers like Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, and Harrisburg. It ends a practice referred to as prison gerrymandering. Mark Nordenberg, chairman of the Commonwealth's Legislative Redistricting Commission, broke a 2-2 tie, siding with Democrats.
Pennsylvania state correctional institutions disproportionately house people of color from urban areas, but they are located in more white rural communities. And because of that, those white rural communities have more legislative power than they otherwise would.
The commission doesn't know when they'll get updated data from the Department of Corrections, though a 2019 study by the Attorney General's office found nearly 25% of all state inmates came from Philadelphia County. What will this ultimately mean for you? Well, Niebler says not much, unless you live near the edge of your district.
It's unlikely to change the maps a huge amount. You know, my sense is that it will have an impact at the margins in terms of the boundaries of specific districts.
The commission says they'd like to have new maps drawn by January. With your Fox 43 Capitol Beat, I'm Matt Maisel.